Hey everybody, it's Ivan with KipBadger.com here today to bring you not a gear review, but actually a tactical slash safety tip. I guess we'll call it that. What we're actually talking about, as mundane as it sounds, is finger placement. Four weapon safety rules, go through them all the time when you go to the range, one of which, keep your fingers straightened off the trigger until you're ready to fire, or something to that effect. That said, possibly in some situations, there's a better way to go about that. What I'm talking about is, rather than having your fingers straight and off the trigger like this, to actually keep tension on it. With every weapon system, it's going to be different as far as where you're going to want that tension, either out front of the trigger guard, up here on the slide frame. Totally depends on the weapon system you're using. But ultimately, what we're talking about is creating positive tension and keeping space. When I refer to space and time, I'm referring to the space needed and the time needed to manipulate my finger into the trigger guard onto the trigger. This I'm accomplishing with keeping that firm index somewhere on my weapon's frame or slide. Having your fingers straightened off the trigger obviously gives us an advantage safety-wise. Partner bumps into you, trip and fall, you're not going to accidentally discharge your weapon. There's certain times, though, where having your finger indexed as such is advantageous. Whether you're a law enforcement officer, having to have your weapon out, moving through a crowd, or even as a homeowner, trying to move through your house, hearing something go bump in the middle of the night, having to break corners. Anytime that someone has a potential to grab your weapon, this is where this shines. In doing so, what you're basically creating is that space and time I talked about in order to you break down your finger and bring it down into the trigger guard when someone is trying to grab your weapon, creating that space and time. Finger straightened along the side of your weapon, and someone clamps on there, you're not going to win that fight. All these fingers is way stronger than your one finger. They get there, it's a fight, you get what you get, who knows what you're gonna get. That said, if someone's trying to grab my weapon, I would probably like the ability to use that weapon that I brought. This allows for it. Rifle, pistol, shotgun, doesn't matter. Feeling that little bit of pressure if someone's trying to grab it, break your finger down, get in a trigger guard, turn your weapon, fire if need be. Is this a catch-all magical thing? No. Does it have use? I feel it does. Prove it out like anything. If you have a blue gun or something like that, go with some of your training partners, prove it out with a blue gun. Try it both ways, see what works. You lose nothing speed-wise or anything else like this, safety-wise. Only have stuff to gain. That said, if it doesn't work for you, don't use it. At any rate, thanks for joining us and checking in to KipBadger.com. Hope to see you next time.